Dear Harstem, first of all, I realize I'm not an amazing StarCraft 2 player. I only started playing last year, but have reached Platinum League. I know that I lapse in my micro, but I felt my macro was decent this game. My supply stayed up and I consistently had more workers and army. Here's what I thought, I played well. 1. I controlled the mid game. 2. I maintained good army supply. Here are some of the ways I can improve. Holy crap, this guy wrote an essay. Number 1. My mineral lines were oversaturated. 2. My drops were not effective. Shield batteries prevented worker damage, so I just tried to depower buildings. All they did was keep Protoss on his side of the map. 3. I did not micro my army well. I struggle to micro drops and pushes at the same time, so I tend to do one or the other. My opponent just A moves with a deadpool. 4. I get supply capped. If I played perfectly, I would not be in Platinum League. I believe, overall, I played better than my opponent. I had significantly better macro and was more proactive. My opponent macroed like Silver League and never moved out. As my boxing coach used to say, you don't have to be the best, just better than the other guy. I believe I have stronger fundamentals than the Protoss player. Early game. I scout what I think is an all-in, so I built a couple of bunkers on the low ground. I scouted again and lost my Reaper. But I saw two Adepts and a Forge. At this point, I'm confident it is a 1 base all-in with plus 1. Possibly Glaze or Charge, if he proxy this Twilight. I wasn't certain, but I play against a lot of all-ins on the ladder. I build two bunkers and wait for the push. Which never came. Mid-game. I took firm control of the game. I denied his third base for a time, before pushing at 10 minutes and 14 minutes. In these fights I traded with my opponent well. I took better engagement, I maintained an advantage in army supply and workers. After the engagement at 14 minutes he had 2 army, 2 supply to my 70. With my next push... Jesus! With my next push I aimed to take the position between his natural and third to end the game. I had the upgrade advantage, I had the army advantage and a composition that should trade well in a fight. This is where I lost the game. I sieged my tank and EMP'd his army, which had flanked mine. I thought I had the composition and numbers to take the fight, mostly Marauders with concussive shells to deal with Colossi and Zealots. He A-moved with Zealots and Colossi. After being ahead all game, he A-moved me and I lost. I probably could have taken the fight if I had split and stutter-stepped multiple groups of Marauders. I used my splash damage spell, I had the high ground, I had tank siege, I had the upgrade advantage. He A-moved with half my number of Zealot and Colossi and ended the game. I could have taken a better engagement if I had microed and dropped at the same time. He gave me a bad manner GG, so I floated my buildings. He continued to bad manner me after the game. Here is the imbalance. Terran does not have the ability to rebound from a bad engagement. I was not dead after the last fight, but I was behind. Reinforcements can only trickle in from the main base instead of being warped in all at once, when and where I need them. My main comeback spells, EMP and anti-armor missile, only work if I have already a critical mass of marine slash marauder. They alone cannot equalize the game, especially against supply efficient units like Archons and Colossi. Storm and Colossi on the other hand can reliably and proactively equalize the game, even from behind. When two imperfect players compete, Protoss can have worse fundamentals, play more passively and still win, because Terran is punished more for any mistake. So Harstem. Is it Imba or do I suck? Good lord. This is like your thesis defense. You wrote an entire thesis here, my friend. It's an actual essay. That took me almost 4 minutes to read. That is not okay, okay? I'm gonna deduct some grades of your final grade for that already, because it seems like we have quite a scholar here, so I'm gonna grade him like he's back in school. And I'll be grading him on a couple of things, of course, and we'll all do that at the end. But for now, the question is it Imba or does he suck? School edition. And 5 minute initial essay edition. This is the longest letter I think I've ever gotten. And now don't think that you're going to be funny and write an even longer letter, because I'm not even going to read it. Usually I don't really... Like, I only read the top part, like the first two lines, and if I think it's good, I open the OBS and start recording. And I think that that process of mine now needs to be changed because of people like, what was he called? Eckbert. Eckbert, you're ruining my workflow. and I think this spell is about to ruin your life. All right, what do we have here? Well, we can skip the early game a little bit. It's not gonna be too interesting, I think. Just making sure that both players have something that resembles a build order. Well, the Terran has something that resembles a build order. I think he cut one worker temporarily, but I mean, we're in Platinum League. These are not the things that I truly care about, all right? The Reaper starts, Orbital Command should start immediately, and he should walk down with it. Yeah, it's all a little bit slow. It's all a little delayed, but I mean, his opponent is opening two gate. Tried the Reaper Wall and then failed the Reaper Wall. So far, 1-0 for the Terran. It's like watching a football match between two guys, and one guy constantly is hitting the ball with his hands, but the other guy is still stuck in his shirt and doesn't know how to put on the shoes the correct way. In this analogy, the guy without the shirt is the Protoss player, and the guy slapping the ball with his hands is the Terran. But yeah, it's not looking too great so far. All right, it's not the cleanest game in the first 2.5 minutes. I like his riding style more than I like his build order. Okay, interesting call. Pulls all his workers and throws down a forge. Sometimes when I watch lower level games, it feels like time moves slower, but it's not actually, things just go a lot slower. It's like watching a turtle and you're not quite sure if it's in slow motion or not. It's like, no, that's really the speed of the turtle. Okay, so he scouts forge at the 3 minute mark and two adepts, and he sees that there's no second base. Now a forge upgrade would hit about, what is it, two minutes from now. So he knows that if this is an actual timing attack and his opponent's going to use the forge, he won't really need to over prepare for it until 2 minutes from now. This is something you always got to keep in mind, is that if you scout a dark shrine the moment it starts, you still have about 75 to 80 seconds, in combination with the DTs having to walk to your base, of course, to respond to it. And the worst thing to do is to respond immediately, because then you're cutting most of the time economy or infrastructure while you don't need to do that yet. This is why very often at lower levels, just building a dark shrine is worth it, because the other person will immediately overreact, getting like 3 cannons in every base, and then you don't even have to build a single DT and it's already worth it. So we see Ekbert kind of, I mean, I don't mind his what he's doing here, you know, second bunker for safety. I understand that, like it is kind of overreacting initially, and he doesn't really have any follow-up. Also, if he thinks he's gonna get attacked, isn't it really weird to play two Hellions? The Hellion probably is the worst defensive unit in the game against Protoss. Like, it doesn't actually beat any unit that Protoss has. Mine is better against Adept, mine is better against Zealots, Tank, Cyclone, all better defensive units. The Hellion is good for scouting, so I wouldn't have minded if he would have built one and then sent it across the map for scouting. But that's not at all what Ekbert is doing here. Oh, I miscontrol a little bit. My bad. Ekbert's gonna send his first Liberator across the map and is up 10 workers. He was up 9 workers. See the Protoss go for a rope. What are these cannons? Very odd game here. Very odd. 2 e-base, okay. Now this is what we call a classic non-build order, okay? So how do you recognize a non-build order? It's very simple. It is whenever you see someone build 2 e-base, well, they have 0 gas and 600 minerals in the bank. He still needs to build his tech labs, his reactors. He probably wants to get another tank after this. He needs to start, at some point he's going to need to start his combat shield as well. These 2 e-base are not going to get used for quite some time. Well, these are all small errors compared to what the Protoss is doing so far, because yeah, the Protoss has a build order here that I haven't seen before. It's just, in chess, I think they call this a completely unique game, you know, because chess very often has repeat moves. So like the first like 5 moves very often are, they've been played like a million times before, and they have like this massive database of moves. Now, if we had this massive database of games, I feel like after minute, like maybe after the 5 seconds, we already had a completely unique game, because the things Big Dirty and Ekbert are doing here are quite unique. Okay, Colossi, Twilight Council. Has he? Okay, he has plus one. That's cool. Egbert, meanwhile, oh, starting his plus one. One of the eBays working now. Second eBay is gonna start now. Not gonna start. Third CC. I mean, Egbert definitely is macroing better here. So far, I'd give him about a 6. 6 out of 10, okay? We're gonna be using the Dutch grading system. I never understand how the letters work. Like, A is the best, F is the worst. But I don't quite know what corresponds with, like, a sufficient grade. Like, is a C fine, or is a D still fine? And you also have, like, pluses. Like, what is a D plus? Is D plus better than D minus? I'm not sure. I actually don't know. I think D plus is better, because A plus is the highest, so it makes sense. But I'm not sure if, like, for us, like, if you get a 6, you know, you can pass on to the next grade or whatever if everything's a 6. I guess it would be, like, a D or a C. B would be, like, a 7, 8. A would be 9, 10. Or A would be 9. A plus would be 10. Something like that, I think. We're just going to be using numbers, easier for my brain. So far, his macro and build order has been about a... Yeah, 6.5. Give it a, it's good enough, you know? We can live with it. It is probably better than the average Platinum player, I would say. So, yeah. 6. What did I say? 6.5? Yeah, 6.5, I think, is absolutely fair. Maybe a 6. But pushing towards 6.5. That's what I'll give Egbert so far. Protoss player. Hasn't scouted anything yet, by the way. I mean, why would you scout? This guy is so brilliant. He's like, I can save 50 minerals of a probe by not scouting, and instead of that, I'll just build cannons all around my base. That will only cost me, what? So it's like 900, and a couple of batteries next to it, like 1100, 1200 minerals. But then he gets to save the cost of one extra probe that he could send across the map, or the cost of a observer, which is 25 minerals, 75 gas. So that's really nice, yeah. That's just it's a great economical thinking here out of Big Dirty. But we're here to look at Egbert, my bad. Sorry, guys. Focusing on Egbert. Okay, he moves across the map. He's looking pretty okay, I'm not gonna lie. And then Shockwave on the way, he's up 20 supply. He has Stim, he has Combat Shield, he has plus one. You siege up. Said, you siege up. This always kind of pains me, is how unaware people are of the dangers that could be there, you know? Like, he just went to this pylon, walked forward with the tanks. If, like, 25 charge slots arrived from the left side, he would be in a world of trouble. But luckily that didn't happen. But it's just one of these things that, to me, is crazy. Because I know if these tanks were exposed and I'd be playing against it, I'd be on top of that with the Zed. I'm so fast, guys. I don't want to brag, but when it comes to A moving on top of tanks, yeah, that's my specialty. I feel like this orbital has been here for a while. You can see that by the fact that it has 99 energy already. 63 workers. He mentioned a slight oversaturation though, so it would be pretty lame if we then start complaining about the oversaturation. That would be pretty lame. Now, this is something that is really a classic mistake out of the Terran. And that is, when you're ahead in general, this is not just for Terran, but when you're ahead in general, so you have an extra base over your opponent is on 2 base, and you're on 3, what you can do is you can just sit back, because the longer the game goes, the better it gets for you. And what you start preparing is basically a next timing push. So you start investing with your advantage into a future timing push, so that you're sure that he can never take a third base again. Now, that could look like exactly getting 2-2 upgrades, getting that enhanced shockwave, and probably already having this base mining for a bit. I didn't like the double drop too much, because dropping into a 2-base toss, I mean, the distance between the main and the natural is so small that it tends to not be very useful. So I wouldn't... What is this? It's almost like an arrow, you know? You can kind of see it here. It's like an arrow, and then here would be a line behind it. It's kind of a lame arrow, though. Yeah, it's not really an arrow at all. It's just 5 pylons randomly built. Never mind. I always try to, you know, look for intention, when very often there is no intention whatsoever. It's just incompetence. That's okay as well. Okay. I mean, the Terran's just absolutely winning here. Terran has no idea that he's winning. Once again, goes for a double drop. This time I don't mind it as much, but the Terran doesn't know that this is better now, because he isn't aware that there's a third base coming up. Very often when you're dropping, you also want to be doing something somewhere else, but I mean, he mentioned that he doesn't have an easy time multitasking. So we're gonna have a quick look at his multitasking. This is not really multitasking. This is something that Terrans do as well. I hate to generalize, but it's always the Terrans as well. It's just because you're dropping with two medevacs doesn't mean you're multitasking. Multitasking, not many people know this, but multi actually is the Latin word for many. Both of them have an M as well, so you can kind of see how that went over the ages, you know, from Latin, you go to Spanish, and then from Spanish to like the Germanic languages, and Germanic language to, bam, British English, and you have many. Multi means many, and task is something that you're doing. So, for example, dropping. However, this was just a monotask. This was not multitasking, this was mono. And mono, that is actually an Italian word, not many people know this, the Italian word, and it means one. That's the, it's, yeah, mono, deux, trois, quatre. It's the first four in Italian.
What the hell, Kevin?
So he just did monotasking, but because it's dropping, he pretends like it's multitasking. But there's a big difference here. We're gonna follow him once again. Let's see how the multitasking this time is gonna happen. I'll just speed it up a bit, huh? Flies back home. Wait, am I actually on his camera? No way, right? Okay, yeah, I'm on his camera now. Okay, look at this. Here comes the multitasking. So he queues up the drops. Starts a planetary. He's maxed, by the way. Now would be a perfect time to hit a timing. He has 2-2 upgrades. He has the upgrade for Ghost. He has a massive army supply advantage. Then he flies into a cannon. Then he drops. Okay, and now the multitask comes in. You can't pretend that you're doing many things at the same time and say that that's one of the reasons why you're not controlling your army so well. The reason why you're not controlling your army so well is because you just don't have very good army control. And that's okay to say. But don't lie to me. It's a little bit messed up. Deducted one grade for lying. The maximum you can get right now is a 9. It's kind of messed up, my friend. It's kind of messed up. Lying to your mentor, your teacher. The man who's supposed to give you advice. So he moves forward. Hellion, as a scout, I like that. I don't mind that. Decides to attack. Oh, crap. Accidentally pressed the plus. Straight into the base with lots of cannons. But I mean, there's cannons everywhere, so I don't even really mind it. Perhaps a scan forward to see what the army is looking like. That would have been nice, especially because he does have... he doesn't have that many, actually. He does have one scan available, but not that many. Yeah, it's a win. I still feel like that a lot of the micro is negative micro. No? If we just look at these armies and how the fight went here, let's just have a quick look at how my man controls everything here, okay? So he has... What does he have? What's he doing? Okay, he has everything in the same control group, so it's probably just F2, which means he can EMP, but he just move commanding forward now. Okay, then he EMPs. Now comes the stim. Now comes the stim. Now comes the moves forward again. So we're not conga. He just stimmed twice? Then right clicks a pylon. Yeah, I think if he just A moved, it would have actually been better. Because now, this wasn't even stutter stepping either. Why does he lie? He said he was microing, like stutter stepping. There's everything in one control group. Which means that if you would be stutter-stepping back, the Vikings also start stutter-stepping back. I mean, he's up 80 supply. He can just send anything across the map, no? He's like 70 more army supply. There's a bunch of units in here as well. He's still afraid of that early game all-in. That early forge really did something to him, to his mental state. Okay, so he leaves these tanks to die. And rallies a ghost for it, which has a good EMP. Okay, you probably want to get these over as well now. Maybe it's still okay, actually. There's not enough meta effects. Vikings could land. Vikings could land. He's not F2-ing though, you see that? So he just control groups everything in one control. Oh no, this was an F2, never mind. No, no, he's an F2-er, he's an F2-er. Oh. I lied, okay. So these works aren't doing anything. We have 4k minerals. What's our production looking like? We have 5 barracks, 2 factories. Why do we have 2 factories? No, it doesn't matter. Okay, so this is a piece of advice that I very often give here in this series, and it's actually very simple. And it's basically, don't copy the pro gamer's production, okay? People very often, they look at pro gamers and they go, hey, this pro gamer has 5 barracks, a factory, and a starport on 3 base. I'm gonna do the same thing. But that's not how it works. You should be trying to copy the early game of the pro gamer, but if you're floating 4k minerals and 1000 gas, there's no shame in adding 3 barracks, okay? I'm not gonna deduct any points. Minus 0.25 for this, okay? Just small amount, but it's... This is an ego thing most of the time, okay? And having an ego isn't very good if you want to become a StarCraft player, because most of the time you're just going to spend losing games. It's just how it is, okay? That's the law of StarCraft 2. No one actually wins. There's like 2 guys at the top that win. Serral, Rainer, now you have Clem as well, and there's a bunch of Korean dudes that take all of our money. It's like, there's no shot, okay? You're a foreign Terran player. In the entire history of StarCraft, like 3 foreign Terran players that won a tournament. Now is not the time for an ego. But you managed to get across the map, which is nice. Still only single medevac is kind of low, huh? Okay, there's nukes as well. Okay. But you're not... Are you really microing? I'm not sure if you're actually microing or just moving your army. You know what I mean? Yeah, I don't think this counts as micro. You're just moving the army and I say, look, I'm microing. It's like the guys that do push-ups, but in reality, they just go like this. They never really go like this, you know? They're just shaking their arms really fast and counting at the same time. That's what you're doing as well. It doesn't count. Like, you can just move back and forth a couple of times. Still, you're very far ahead and you're winning by a lot. You're gonna hit another timing, a 3-3 timing this time around. You're gonna be up like 80 supply. You're gonna be up 3 upgrades. But yeah, the micro definitely is an issue. And not the fact that you do it poorly, but the fact that you do it at all. You should probably just A move, like stim and A move. Is probably better at this point. Ooh, cloakers. I like this, Egbert. Nice. Oh, look, even splitting them up. I feel like you have a lot of potential, Egbert. I'm not gonna lie. You're a scholar, first of all. Intelligent person. I could see that immediately after reading your essay. Okay, you split them up just for them to come together. Whoop, whoop, whoop. There's no observer. It's gonna work. No, there's an observer. It's not gonna work. Well, that was a good attempt. You know, I could say, well, maybe you need to split them up rather than have 3 at the same spot. And then maybe you would do more damage. But don't believe the haters, Egbert. I think it was cool. And sometimes even if something is bad, it is more important than that it's cool than that it's bad. You know? You know what I'm saying? It's like clothes as well. It's like if we didn't care at all about how cool they were, everyone would just be walking around in sweatpants because they're the best. They have large pockets, they're comfortable, they keep you warm. Yeah, that's it. Really the only things that matter. But now people want to look cool in their clothes. And it's the same here, you know? Basically, the thing that you just bought $500 pants from Calvin Klein. I think they sell pants, probably. Or Levi pants aren't that expensive. Armani pants. $500 Armani pants is what you just bought, okay? And you're always gonna have the haters that say, well, why wouldn't you just buy cheaper pants? And it's the same here. You're always gonna have haters that say, why wouldn't you just send one ghost to this base, and one ghost to this base, and one ghost here, and move your army at the same time, or maybe use your 3-3 timing. But these people aren't cool, and they don't have the same drip, you know? They don't have... the same style. Sheesh. That's fire. Lit. It's for the zoomers. My metrics showed that mainly people above, I think it's like 35 watch my videos. So the last few days I've been studying TikTok to see what's cool these days for the zoomers, the kids, the Generation X, the pre-millennials. And words like sheesh and lit do very well is what I've found. Okay, here we have another attack. So basically what happened here is initially our good friend Taren was up about 50 or 60 army supply and up 3 upgrades. Then he decided to wait as long as it took for this Protoss to get his +1 armor upgrade and to get another 90 army supply as well. So that's very cool. Very, very cool indeed. So the Protoss has less workers, has a bigger army, and on top of that, look at this. 4 Marines, 2 Marines, that is 6 supply. Then there's 4 Marines here, 10 supply for Marauders, 18 supply. So we have about, 23 supply over here. Oh, another tank in here, Marauder. So you're missing about, 30 supply. You're already down 12 supply. So basically, this is 95 supply, okay? 95 supply-ish, 90 maybe, against 136. So you're down 45, 46 supply in this fight. Let's keep that in mind, okay? You're up 2 upgrades, which always is important. Oh, good lord. You hit good EMPs? Very good EMPs even. Okay, one more time. Did you just walk into your opponent's Archons? It's over here. Okay, so the tank shoot. We get a stim. No, everything the same control group. So he needs the EMP first because the ghost has priority. Most of them are just walking. Now they start shooting. After he loses 40 supply, he starts shooting. He hasn't stimmed. He hasn't stimmed. Yeah, he lost 6k more than his opponent. That was a terrible fight. Okay, now what you're supposed to do is you start base trading like your life depends on it. You have a crap ton of money. It's still maybe possible, okay? You put the tank here on the high ground. You get like a bunker over here or something. And you start dropping the other side. Like, get this base down, get this base down. Maybe go into their main base, try to get their production as well. With whatever you have, okay? That is all you can do right now. It's literally the only... Oh, maybe. If he goes over here... And you have a lot of money. And you're... Oh my god. You're lacking gas. You have a lot of bases though. You could float one. Okay, you have a single drop. I kind of like that single drop. But you need to remember that you're already down a lot. So you actually... Yeah. You probably need to do like a full base trade. Or you can't base trade at all. Like full base trade scenario. Like this is... You can't half it. You know? You need to... Yeah, you need to fully do it. Is this single drop gonna force this entire army? What is this drop? What are we looking at here? Okay, he drops 4 to the right and 4 on the left. He wanted to flank the probes in the gas. That's something I haven't seen before. Okay, recall forces an army back. It's possible, guys. It's possible. Okay, picks up. Once again, the mono task going very strong. Orbital command flying over. What are these workers doing? Maybe you want to send them into gas? No? No, maybe no. Oh! Ah, very unfortunate. Probably got F2'd. Yeah, got F2'd. Yeah, nice try. I like this though. This is a good move. This is a very good move. The F2 wasn't a good move, but the rest was fine. These workers here is like an outpost. I once heard that a strategy to detonate landmines is that they would send a bunch of goats into like a minefield, and then the mines would explode on the goats to clear like minefields. I can't remember where this was. I remember hearing about it. It could also be an urban myth. These SCVs tried doing the same, except there were no mines, but storms. Maybe just testing the waters, I don't know. Maybe it's not the same at all, but I just want to share that anecdote. Okay. 135 supply to 136. So army supply relatively close. But at this point, the army quality of the Protoss is actually a million times better. He has so many heavy tech units. Look at that. Colossi, 7 Archons, 9 Templar, 2 Storms each. Did I say 4 Immortals already? I think so. It's like massive, massively over-teched army. And his opponent is super basic. Like, this is basically a tier 1 army, you know? Marines, Marauders, 2 tanks that get cleared immediately, and a single Viking. He doesn't stim again. But why? Yeah, this wasn't a very close fight at all. This really wasn't a very close fight. Okay, well, this game is pretty over now. I mean, if you can't win when you're up 90 supply, it's hard for me to believe that you'll win being down 80 supply. Nice! The offensive GG. I guess Big Dirty had similar thoughts as I did. I was like, alright, I was really dead this game, and now I won like 4 fights in a row. There's no way I'm losing this. And Egbert GG's back as well. Oh, is he floating? I think he's floating. Let's see what's gonna happen here then. I think he mentioned some bad manner as well. I guess the GG is pretty bad manner. I do not approve of the GG. I don't think it's a cool thing to do. But it was pretty funny. You know, sometimes you just... Ooh, nice recall. Nice recall. Whoop. Back home immediately. Beautiful recall click there. Wow. That is not doing much of anything. I mean, he's completely dead, right? He's actually completely dead. Yeah, there's nothing there. He's gonna go home. Ah, he's just gonna stall for a bit now or what? Guess Marine and Marauder go down. There's still a little bit of army left in the main base and some Marines and Marauders here, but yeah, the rest of this seems pretty over. Ah, oh, he's actually gonna float. We'll just speed it up a bit then. Stop. It's over. Enjoy how? You give me a bad manner, GG. How? Okay, this was a mistake. You can already feel it. There's too long of a break, and we know Egbert is a big fan of writing essays. So I'm expecting... Oh, you said DG, then they resign. That's not too bad. Yeah, he is correct. Egbert is correct. It was a little bit bad manner. The game was completely over. You weren't still in the game. It was over, Egbert. Let's not fool ourselves here, my friend. This guy feels like a fake person, yo. What? Question mark, explanation mark? What did he say before? Stop. It is over. He sounds like someone that you'd see in like the drug prevention videos. You know? When there's like 3 kids like smoking weed and then he comes over. Stop, guys. It's over. Didn't you know that drugs are bad for you? And then the other 3 smoking weed. Oh, we had no idea. It's like, yes, drink some water instead. That is way better than those nasty drugs. You know who uses drugs? Losers. Oh, we're no losers. Nice. And then they all smile at the camera and like they wave like this or something like this. Like some 80s drug prevention video. I feel like Big Dirty would be great for this. What? I'ma go make a sandwich. See ya. I had upgrade advantage all game. 75 mineral structure shuts down all harass. What structure is he talking about? The cannon? Does he think cannons cost 75? Or the battery? He probably thinks the battery costs 75. Get EMP detect through a choke into an army with better upgrades? Is he just making up fights? Or did I just miss half the game? I feel like both of these guys saw a different game than I did. I can't believe people actually do this to each other. Why wouldn't you just leave? You're wasting your own time, no? Don't they have better things to do? Big Dirty wins? And this proves that it actually was Egbert who sent in the replay. Because he left the game after... Why would you send this in? I'd be embarrassed to show this. Holy crap. I'm gonna have to give you a grade now, don't I? Alright. I don't even know where to start. Okay, let's start with your lies. I think you lost 2 full points for that at this point. So from a 10, you went to an 8 already. Okay, that's the starting point. I also, because you have an ego, I took out minus 0.25. You cried so much during the game, and then you floated. It's like, turn the other cheek or be a bigger man, you know? This wasn't it. So another minus 1.75. So it's nice, you know, the 0.25 that I deducted earlier. Right now you're on a 6. If you played absolutely perfect this game, just because you lied and because you're a little bit of a dick, you already have 6 right now, okay? You forgot the stim in 2 of the fights. The most important spell that Terran has that increases DPS by a crap ton. You just didn't use it. For every fight you didn't stim, minus 1. Right now you're at a 4, okay? You're at a 4. Your timings make absolutely no sense. You're up like 60, 70 supply. Then you wait until you're not up in supply anymore. The upgrade gap gets closed a little bit more. And then you attack. That was the last fight. You get minus 1 for that last fight. For the timing of the fight. You get... so you're at 3 right now, I think. Okay. Then the early game to mid game. It wasn't great, but I think it was... good enough. Like you played at a platinum as a platinum level player, and you did okay. You know, you had a semi build order. You attacked at an okay timing. You got very far ahead. Then afterwards, you lost 4 tanks for free. So I'm gonna take another for the first 3 fights together. I'm also gonna give you minus 1. So then you'll have 2 left. I think that's completely fair for you. You didn't really micro. You lost a lot for that. You're a bit of a prick, and all your timings were bad. The only thing that you did do relatively well is that you just had a lot of crap, especially in the first 15 minutes. You had a lot of crap, and you moved it across the map at times. That is really just what you did. And you get a 2 out of 10 for that, so I'm sorry, sir. You have to redo this year, and you suck. That's going to be my judgment. You can, of course, appeal at the exam board or the exam commission, and we'll have some other people look at it. But until then, you suck. And no graduation for you. I'm sorry. All right. That's going to be it for this episode of Is It Imba or Do I Suck? If you thought this was a fantastic episode, be sure to hit the like button. Yes, that's very nice. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and share this with your friends and with your family as well, of course. Nothing better than watching Iolis together with your brother, or your sister, or your cousin, your dad, your mom, your grandma or grandpa. It's not like the average age of my YouTube videos can get any higher anyway, so that's all good. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.